My name is Käthrine. I'm from Sweden, Stockholm. And in many ways, Nippon Nordic has been very transitional for me. Like I mentioned, I'm actually from Sweden, but my parents are from China. So I'm a second generation immigrant, but I'm making the decision to move to Japan next year to work. So I'm going to be a full-on immigrant. And with all these kind of preparations that I'm doing, it's influenced my work quite a lot, which is called Mammoth in Baboon. My aim is to create a picture book, largely because I'm thinking that if I can set this picture book, if the story speaks to the audience, then I can take it further to an animated short or an animated series. So, as the title suggests, it's about a mammoth. Mammoth's name is Mona. She's a shop vendor selling banana ice cream in Baboon Market. Like everyone else at this market, she's trying her best to stay competitive. She's been doing it for quite some years, and she's working very, very hard. At this market, there are Baboons that sell fried bananas, banana smoothies, banana bread, fried bananas, all kinds of bananas. And sometimes she gets funny looks from all the other vendors, but she has to ignore them. At this market, Mona really enjoys looking at the passerbys. And one day, she spots a little baboon girl called Bobby. She's part of this little family group, merrily kind of running through the market. But because Bobby is extra curious, it brings Mona back to her own memories of the past when she was a little young mammoth girl. So here, Mona is very young. She doesn't quite understand that a serious storm has stricken and her whole family needs to move. So she wanders off thinking, oh, I'll just go back to my family herd. But she somehow winds up on this ice raft where she gets more and more lost and flows further and further away from Mammoth Mountain to Baboon City, where it's hot, it's humid, she sweats a lot, it's nothing like Mammoth Mountain. But Mona realizes that she just needs to survive and fit in. So she tries her best to learn Baboonish. She tries to adapt the latest fashions to fit in. She even learns to appreciate mushy bananas, although she doesn't quite like it. So that's her memory. But then a sudden storm falls upon this market, which is quite rare, and everyone is running from the rain. And here you can see that Bobby is actually truly lost. And Mona, when she sees Bobby, she realizes that, oh, she's actually just as lost as I was. She's a baboon. And with that, Mona also realizes that there are advantages to being a big mammoth. She doesn't need to be a baboon to be part of Baboon Town. And sometimes it can be quite handy to be a big mammoth. a work in progress, so I'd like to talk a little bit about how I worked and how I'm hoping that with your help, perhaps developing the story further. So I've mainly written and drawn at the same time, not only because my end goal, my mission end goal is for to become a picture, but also because I find this format to inform the style, the language, and the pacing of the story. A good example that I think of is a Danish poet by, her work is very influenced by personal stories from her grandmother and her childhood, and it's also narrated similar to a picture book. So that is the main inspiration, and that's my argument where I feel like it could actually work as an animated short or an animated series. Stylistically, these are a couple of artists and artists that I really like. Quentin Blake, Peter Davies, and Sean Kahn. They all use like colors and layers of texture very effectively. But I think what I like the most is that they really focus on the child as the main character, where it feels very genuine. It's told a lot of heart. And on that note, I'd like to leave you with myself as a little kid. Because here I'm either making noodles or pasta. I'm not quite sure. I guess you like that.
Serialized afterwards? Is there a new conflict to be tackling with these characters?
I'm thinking that I'm going to tell stories around being lost, as I feel like, especially nowadays, quite so much happening in the world, and it's a theme that like a lot of people have just received in their lives and relate to. Starting point, so I can't say that I